बिल्कुल भाई, जिस तरह हम लोग श्रवण कर रहे राधे राधे जी, तो सारी ये सारी कृष्ण देव की माया रोशन कर रहे हैं, इसमें एक बिल्कुल माया क्या तुम इस समय अपने प्रयत्न से विरही हो गई हो, अथवा तुम प्रयत्न के किसी दोस्त को देखकर अत्यंत दुख हो रही हो, अथवा तुमसे कोई बड़ा अपराध हो गया है जिसके कारण तुम्हारी प्रति भंग हो जाएगी, इस आशंका से जाए, अथवा जब भी तुमने स्वयं कोई अन्याय नहीं किया फिर भी कोई फल व्यक्ति तुम्हारी विरुद्ध तुम्हारे कंध के पास मुख था अभिजोग लगाकर किसी को नष्ट करने के लिए चेष्टा कर रहा है,
हरे कृष्णा, प्लीज चेक हिंदी साउंड इज ऑडिबल, हिंदी साउंड इज ऑडिबल, प्लीज चेक, हरे कृष्णा।
हाय हाय, मैंने जिस प्रकार तिरस्कार करने के लिए नितिन गुजरों के द्वारा प्रस्तुत हुई है, उसी प्रकार तुम क्या अपनी प्रतिवादी गुरुगुरु के द्वारा पुरस्कृत हुई हो, क्या इसलिए तुम इस प्रकार से विषाद का अनुभव कर रही हो? अच्छा, ये समस्त प्रश्न किसका है, किसका है?
सो हु इज आस्किंग ऑल दैट दोस क्वेश्चन? श्रीमती राज, श्रीमती राधिका इज आस्किंग द सेम क्वेश्चन हर सेल्फ
कृष्ण को।
सो शी इज आस्किंग द सेम क्वेश्चन टू द लेडी हु इज गेटिंग द फॉर्म ऑफ कृष्ण, गोपी, कृष्ण इज द गेटिंग। So now we are going to start the Shlok 10. The continued silence of the beautiful young damsels only served to increase Sri Radha's apprehension. Oh, commonly one, she said, has your co-wife become proud, intoxicated by her teeny drop of good fortune? Has her intelligence become corrupt, and as a result, has she pierced your heart with the arrows of the sharp words? No, surely this could not happen to you.
हमने भगवती पूर्णमा से देवी से नीचे सुना है कि मोहिनी नामक
ओ मून फेस वन, वी हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम भगवती पूर्णमासी देवी दैट देयर वॉज वंस एन इनकार्नेशन ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड नेम मोहिनी हु वॉज सो एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डनरी लवली दैट शी कुड एनचेंट द ग्रेट महादेव लॉर्ड शिवा।
महादेव को
माई वॉइस इज ओके, प्लीज चेक. हरे कृष्ण. If you saw one another, you would both become so enamored by each other's beauty that you would violate the boundaries of self-composure, and an exceptional and amazing rush would appear from your mutual attraction. So as Sri Krishna discussed, as a celestial damsel continuously drank the nectarian words flowing from the lotus mouth of inquisitive Sri Radhika, he felt a transcendental rapture well up in his heart, and the hairs of his body stood up in ecstasy. In order to hide this, he covered his limbs with his veil. When Sri Radhika saw this, she imagined that the damsel must have some kinds of bodily ailment. O Sakhi, she asked, are you experiencing some discomfort in your body? Are you feeling some pain in your chest, your back, or your head? So in this way, Sri Radhika guessed about the young maiden's illness. O friend Vishakha, she said, my honorable father fondly sent me a precious medicinal oil that is a sure remedy for all kinds of ailments. Please quickly bring it from the house. The nature of love and affection is such that if an article clear to oneself is used for one who is near and dear, its very existence becomes meaningless. So what is the meaning here actually? My father Vishwanu Maharaj, He brought a ointment for me, and he sent to me. So that oil is in my room. So bring that oil. And put that oil on the body of this Devangana. So when I will put the oil in the body of this Devangana, so her suffering or her pain will be less. So because my father has given me this oil, so whatever the labor he has done for bringing all these, so it will be successful. And if I will serve this lady, so I will be so fortunate. In this way, Radhika is saying, Sakhi, O Sakhi Vishakha, I feel deep affection for this Sakhi who has just arrived. So she just saw her and she got love. Ek Shravan Jate Prem aur ek Vishwaramba Prem. हाँ ओ सॉरी स्वाभाविक श्रवण जाति प्रेम, दर्शन जाति प्रेम, स्वाभाविक प्रेम. यस रुक्मणी. So when she Rukmani heard the glories of the Krishna, so she got love with Krishna. Kubja and Darshan Jate Prem Kubja. When she got the darshan of Krishna, she got so much love. So she feels so much love towards Krishna. Gopiya and the spontaneous prem, the Sahajitya prem, that is in the heart of gopis. So gopis has spontaneous love for Krishna. In this way, स्पॉन्टेनियस स्वाभाविक, सहज में स्वाभाविक. सो हियर राधिका, सो सीइंग द लेडी हु गॉट द सीइंग द कृष्णा हु गॉट द फॉर्म ऑफ लेडी, सो सीइंग दैट ही फेल्ट लव फॉर हिम फॉर दैट लेडी. सो इन दिस वे राधा जी इज सीइंग इन दिस वे, ओ सखी विशाखा, आई फील डीप अफेक्शन फॉर दिस सखी हु हैज जस्ट अराइव्ड. दिस ऑयल विच रिमूव्स ऑल डिसीजेस is a manifestation of my father's love for me. Hence, I will use it to massage this beautiful girl's entire body with my own hands. So it is not just oil, it is the sneh, it is the affection. When Bhagwan accepts our offerings, when there is so much affection is there, when there is so much love. In the Gita, Bhagwan is saying, Patram Pushpam Phalam. Three kinds of things or three kinds of bhav people offered me. One is rasik bhav, one is sattvik bhav, one is tamasik bhav. So in this way, so sattvik bhav means here, with the affection and love. So if somebody is offering something with the sneh and affection and love, so Bhagwan accept that. So in this way Radha ji is saying, my father Vishwanu Maharaj, so the oil he brought for me, so it is not just oil, it is his love and affection towards me. And I will, in the same way, so that love in the form of oil, so the new Ramani who has come means the Krishna in the form of Nari, in the lady, so I will massage his whole body because I have a spontaneous love for this lady. So I will also skillfully massage her head, then all her suffering will be relieved. So she is developing so much love and affection towards Krishna. Radha ji is not able to understand that he is Krishna. So she is thinking he is some beautiful lady. So I will also skillfully massage her head, then all her suffering will be relieved. हो जाएगा. सो ऑल द सखीज आर सर्विंग टू राधा जी, बट नाउ राधा जी व्हाट इज शी इज डूइंग, शी इज सो मच ईगर टू सर्व दैट लेडी. सो एंड लिसन, bring some warm water mixed with the finest healing ingredients for me to bathe her in. I will alleviate her suffering and then her lotus-like face will appear happy. Perhaps then she will speak with me. So we should always take the bath with the warm water, lukewarm. So in this way the heat of the body will be in control. मैं तो बर्फ के पानी से करता था. ओ सखीज, आई हैव स्पोकन स्वीट्स एंड जेंटल वर्ड्स टू दिस गर्ल्स एंड आई एम रेडी टू पर्सनली गिव हर एन ऑयल मसाज and other beneficial treatments with an open heart. I have honored her and shown her sincere affection. Still, I have not heard a single word from her lips. She is being deceptive about the nature of her ailment and just sits her here with a doleful face. So Radha ji is saying that I have asked so many questions to this lady and I am ready to serve her, but still she is so much disappointed and sitting here. Now I shall administer a new treatment for this lovely girl's disease, just as the divine nectar tonic given to me by Dhanvantri cures any disease. This remedy will remove within a second all the disease of her body's life force and mind and senses. It will especially serve to nourish her body. So listen and I will tell you more about new treatments. Until now the Sakhis has been sitting here overcome by some incurable disease and incapable of uttering a single word. However, if her whole chest were touched by the lotus-like palms of the lords of our Kunja, she would soon start to talk, giggle and sob. Having experienced the indescribable pleasure of the touch of the rustic Shekhar Shri Krishna's hand, she would murmur in distinct sounds. What more can I say? She would assume such a radiance that we would all laugh without end. Her body would manifest all signs of having met with Shri Krishna, and by his touch all kinds of exceptional symptoms would manifest. This would make us happy. So when Shri Krishna, who was discussed as a heavenly damsel, heard Srimati Radhika speak in this way, a gentle smile appeared on his face. And he concealed his smile and then slightly raised his lowered lotus-like face with the charming fingers of his left hand. He gently brushed a stray curl from his forehead and pulled his veil down over his head and a little further. So the disgust, Shri Krishna's assumed the sweet voice of a young lady and showered alluring words as sweet as nectar upon all those present, like chakori words. Shri Radha and her sakhis drank every word with eager hearts. In this way, the experienced supreme bliss and felt such astonishment that mere words cannot describe. Upon hearing the sweet talk of the beautiful new girl, they revelled in a bliss equaled only by the rapture they felt upon hearing the talk of Shri Krishna himself. The new Sakhi said, "O beautiful Shri Radha, I am a damsel from the heavenly planets. Please hear." Now she started speaking. So after a long time, now she started speaking on the shlok number 21st. Now what she said? She said, I am a damsel from the heavenly planets. I am a devi from the heaven. Please hear why I have come to you with such a agitated heart. I have a desire to know something about a particular matter, and who but you can fulfill my desire. No one else can fulfill my desires except you. So you have to listen to me very carefully, whatever I would like to say. So upon hearing these words, Shri Radhika said, "O lovely one, you have introduced yourself as a heavenly damsel, This is surely not false. In fact, I had guessed as much even before you spoke, because no woman of this mortal world can rival you in beauty. Your beauty is incomparable and unprecedented. Indeed, you are in a class of your own. So what is said in the Vedanta Sutra? Alpavat Alpatat, I don't know. Arupavat. So no one is like him. It means Arupavat. Only he is like him. Arupavat, only he is like him. No one else can be like him. So Mayavati used to say that Bhagwan doesn't have form, or the Shankarvadi, they used to say that Bhagwan doesn't have any kinds of form. Vat means Arupavat. Arupavat tat pradhanat evahi, like this, whose form we cannot compare his form to anyone else. Because if we give the comparison with any form, when we can give the comparison? When there are two things. If there are two things, then we can compare. So if there is more than one thing, so then we can compare. Kya? Superlative, positive, positive, comparative, superlative. Good, better, best. So if there are three things, then we can compare that. If something is equal like, then we can compare. So only one. So the things which is not one jati, the similar, so that we cannot compare. There is background noise, please fix it. Okay, I am just fixing it. Don't worry, Didi. Thank you for letting me know. So in this way, we cannot compare anything with Bhagwan. Please check now, is it okay? Ekameva dutiya nasti. Ekameva dutiya nasti. No one else like Bhagwan. And what kind of form he has? So Bhagwan have a form. So no one is like him. Arupavat. That is why it is saying Arupavat. If so, so if there are two persons and we can compare them, then he is good, he is a scholar and he is more than, scholar than him. So we cannot compare a foolish person with a pandit, the scholar. So in this way, here it is said, Radhaji is saying, so in the Mrtlok, ladies, no one is like you. No one is like you. We cannot compare. You are adorable. So the Braj Sundari, Sundar and Madhurya, It is not possible to compare with this lady. Not possible. And second, who are staying in the heavenly planet, and there the body fragrance of that person is so nice. Now check, it is fixed. Or even in the background, Lakshmi and other devis, the Sondara Madhure. So we cannot compare with the Vrajaramnis. We cannot compare. That's why I say Nayam, Shreya, Nitanti like this. Sajeshta, Narila, Gandha like this. So the beautifulness of the Braj Sundaris is incomparable. We cannot compare with anyone. And if you would like to compare that Braj Ramnis, so only we can compare with Krishna, no one else. Actually, there is so much hot here, so that's why 2-3 fans are, you know, running. So that's why there is this noise. I am, you know, sitting in a so bad place where there is no air, and I am so much sweating this time. Let me check. वॉइस आ रही है
ये कृष्ण की जो सौंदर्य माधुर्य कौन बना
सो नो वन कैन डिस्क्राइब द सौंदर्य माधुर्य ऑफ कृष्ण नाउ चेक प्लीज इज इट ओके इज इट फिक्स्ड
हरि शरद कमल मैंने
Upon hearing this verse, Sri Radhika said, O lovely ones, you have introduced yourself as a heavenly devil sons. Oh, you whose face like a ram resembles an autumnal lotus, I have considered many possible reasons for your sadness, such as feeling separation from your husband, and I have told you of them, but actually I was joking. Please do not take off. Offense to my words. Now you have become affectionate towards me, and I have become yours. So the celestial damsel said, Radha, you are my sakhi. Why are you so reserved? Although I am a heavenly damsel, I have become your subordinate. Do not doubt it. I constantly yearn to be your maid servant so that I may experience one drop of the ocean of your love, beauty and qualities.
Krishna
is saying in this way, in the form of lady. So how is introducing himself? That I am the damsel of a heavenly planet. Please listen carefully while I'll tell you why my heart feels such anguish, and then dispel the doubt that causes me this despair. Your nectar sweet words in my heart, whatever the suffering I have, so please listen to that and please remove that. At that time, one, what happened? So your nectar sweet words have fallen like soft rain upon my heart, but they have not even slightly soothed the distress within it. O Sakhi, the flute songs that is heard in Sri Vrindavan has also entered our heavenly abode. Its power is such that the chaste ladies there no longer wish to embrace their husbands. In fact, the mere thoughts of doing so disgusts them. When the Lord of the universe, Sri Krishna, attracts their minds and hearts, their thoughts no longer run towards their mortal husbands. Anything connected with Sri Krishna has this power. The slightest connection with him completely removes the desire to enjoy anything material. So that Devangana, the lady in the form of Krishna in the form of said, so Krishna's flute sounds went to Swarga, and there is a so much importance of the sounds of the flutes that who are hearing that sound, so they are so much bewildered. And what happened with that? So all those heavenly ladies, they gave up their husbands. So they reach there where the lotus sound is coming, the beautiful sound flutes is flute sounds is coming. So they try to reach there. So this is the important and ras in the sweetness in the sounds of the flutes of the Krishnas. So it is attracting to the gopis, to the ladies who are residing in the heavenly planets. This kinds of Govind's flute sound is like this. Once they hear this kinds of sounds, so they left their all kinds of work. When the gopis hear the sounds of the Krishna's flutes, so they leave everything. Vishambha Gitam Tadanandam Vartate Vraje Sutriya, like this. Itamanusha, their heart and mind has stolen by Krishna's flute sound. And how they are running towards Krishna? Thousands and thousands gopis are running each other with together, and they are not watching each other. Thousands of thousands gopis are running towards Krishna's together, but they are not able to watch each other. What is the reason? Because their heart is so much absorbed in Krishna, and because it has been attracted by the Krishna's sounds flutes, so that's why they are not watching each other. It is Bhagavatam, it is described also, gopis are saying, we had only one mind, one heart, so which has been stolen by you. So in this way gopis are saying. So gopis was sleeping, and when the sounds of the flutes of Govind enter into the ear of the gopis, so that sounds has stolen the heart of the gopis, and they came out calling. Lalkarna means Lalkarna. So in this way, that sounds is giving the challenge to the gopis' hearts, that if you can stop to steal me your heart, so you can. You cannot. Forgetting this kinds of heart, so they are running towards the Krishna's sounds. And Krishna is so much dhurt. Dhurt. One is thief, one is dacoits. So the thief always steal anything by hiding himself. You are sitting here and you have putting your money bag and mobiles somewhere. So what the thief does? He comes in a very hidden way, come to you and will steal everything. And he will see he is so much observed in Katha. Then gradually he will steal everything and he will run away. Very nice. Just like our wire went stole. And the dacoit means they are very dangerous. So He will come before you and he will slap on your cheek 5 times, then he will steal everything and go away. He will snatch everything and will go away. These kinds of dacoits. So in this way, Krishna is Dhur, the dacoit. What is he doing? What is he doing? So Krishna is hiding the valuable. Krishna is stealing the valuable heart of the gopis. And after stealing that, what he does? He is showing to the gopis. They look, I have stolen your heart and now I am going. And I have stolen your heart. Now if you want to stop me, if you can stop me, stop. Stop if you can. So Kashi Naresh calls so many kinds of kings for her daughters. So their three daughters name was Amba Ambalika, Jagdamba. Oh, what was the three name? Amba Ambalika or? So Kashi Naresh, he didn't give invitation to Bhishma. But what Bhishma did? So himself went there. Yes, Amba, Ambika, Ambalika. So काय माने ना अपने मोर लाइक दिस. दिस अ बंगाली प्रोवर्ब. सो समबडी इज गिविंग रेस्पेक्ट इन द ब्लेज टू हिम और इट डजंट मैटर. ही ऑलवेज गिव हिज यू नो इफेक्ट टू एवरीबडी दैट आई एम दिस काइंड्स ऑफ पर्सन. सो इन दिस वे दीपक तांबा वाज नॉट इनवाइटेड इन दैट असेंबली फॉर द मैरिज सेलिब्रेशन बट ही केम देयर. And what he did there? So he did so many kinds of ruling to everybody's, and he has given the challenge to all the kings. So I am kidnapping these three girls, and if you can stop me, please stop. If somebody has power to stop me, so please stop. You are most welcome. And if somebody has the power to fight me, please fight. He was saying like this. He was challenging to everybody. So it is showed in the Mahabharata also. Then all the kings, because all the kings knew the effect, the power of the Bhishma Pitama. That's why Bhishma Pitama. So no one accepted the challenge of Bhishma Pitama. Everybody bowed down their head and sitting quiet. And Bhishma Pitama kidnapped three princes and he put them on his chariot. So what's my meaning to hear is, here Krishna, the sounds of Krishna's flute is so much powerful. When the sounds enter into the ear of the gopis, and it's so this ear is our gate. So the gate was open. So Krishna's sounds enter from through the gate and enter into the heart. So in the heart of the gopis there was so valuable. So he stole the heart of the gopis. So this is the difference between the chor, the thief, and the dacoits. So thieves always steal the things, but he never showed his challenging mood. He never showed anybody his challenging mood. But the dacoits, he showed the challenging moods. Why? He said, oh, just like I have given the example of Bhishma Pitama, because how he has challenged all the kings who were assembled there, because he didn't want to get married, but he had kidnapped both three girls for his चित्र विचित्र चित्रांगदा देर वॉज थ्री प्रिंस वर देयर फॉर देम ही किडनैप दीज थ्री गर्ल्स अम्बा अंबिका मालिका बट दिस इज नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्षत्रिय धर्म इट इज अगेंस्ट इट सो दिस इज द रूल ऑफ द क्षत्रिय धर्म दैट इफ यू आर किडनैपिंग समवन सो यू हैव टू मैरी हर दैट्स वाई हिज परशुराम दैट्स वाई हिज गुरु परशुराम ही वॉज सो मच एंग्री ऑन हिम दैट इफ यू डिडंट वॉन्ट टू गेट मैरी देन वाई डू यू वाई यू हैव किडनैप ऑल दीज गर्ल्स वट वॉज द नीड ऑफ दैट That why you have kidnapped these three girls? Tell me, huh? That's why Parshuram and Mahishma Pitama fought each other. You know this story. So many people used to ask these questions that in the ancient time we have heard so many stories that people used to kidnap. Why they used to do so much marriages? Why? What was the reason behind? Not only they were not satisfied with one marriage. So the answer of that question, so the ancient kings, they used to show their effect, the power to other kings, and they control them by his power. And the second reason is yes, and second they would like to get married with the girls of the king because they would like to get the friendship, they would like to make the friendship of that kings. So if somebody is, you know, in a tying in a relationship, so they will be lovable for each other in this way. They are the two reasons only, no other end, others reasons. चित्रकेतु महाराज आई थिंक गुरुदेव नीड सम वाटर सो नाउ वी आर कंपेयरिंग टू होम So we are giving the example of Krishna's flutes, sounds of flutes. It is so much effective, it is so much powerful that it has stolen the heart of the gopis. Dacoits, chinna, so, kidnap, it has snatched the heart of the gopis. So here it is saying also, श्री कृष्णा अटैक्स देयर माइंड हार्ट देयर ऑल दोस सो लॉन्गर रन टुवर्ड्स देयर मोर्टल हस्बैंड एनीथिंग कनेक्टेड विद श्री कृष्णा हैज दिस पावर द स्लाइटेस्ट कनेक्शन विद हिम कंप्लीटली रिमूव्स द डिजायर टू एंजॉय एनीथिंग मटेरियल
हमारे स्वर्गपुरी का एक नाम है दशालय अर्थात स्तन पर बास्वर कोईश्वर और जीवन इन तीन दशाओं को
So one of the names of our heavenly cities is Tridashalaya, meaning of this place where the inhabitants experience only three stages of life, childhood, adolescence and youth. In this Mrityulok we have seen that people are getting older, got old age, but in the Swargalok, nobody is getting old because why they are getting the nectarian food. Amrit my bhojan. Oh my god, so much hot. So they never grow old. Since none of the women ever age, they all feel attracted to the sounds of the flutes. Who then is in position to rebuke other or joke at their expense. The sounds of the flutes destroy the heavenly damsel's chastity and defeats each other and every one of them. Here, the Devangana, the Krishna, in the form of lady, what he is saying, what she is saying, she is glorifying the. In this way, the influence of the flute songs spread day by day among the heavenly damsels. Then one day, filled with wonder, I thought of myself, from where does this sweet sounds come? Who is playing that flute? I was thinking that whose flute sound is that? Whose? So where this sound is coming from? And who is playing this kinds of sounds? So after thinking all over the things, after consideration, I was able to trace the sounds of the flute from the heavenly planets, and in that way I came down to earth, this earth. I happily stayed at Vanshivat for some days. There I witnessed the unequal pastimes performed by you and Shri Krishna, and I became acquainted with this his dear beloved Sakhis. So how Krishna is saying in this way, I have came from the Swargalok and I stayed at Vanshivat, because Krishna, he used to play so many kinds of times in Vanshivat. There are many Vanshivat in Vrindavan. There are many Vanshivat in Vrindavan. Vanshivat means where Krishna used to play the flute. Where Krishna, he played the flute, that is called Vanshivat, because you manifested Vanshivat there. But still, so if we are talking about the Vanshivat, so there is one Vanshivat is there. Also Vanshivat. Bhandir one. So under the tree of the banyan tree where Krishna played the flute, this is called Vanshivat. Where it is? One is Vanshivat. Vanshivat is? We used to go. Pass me to hai. Bhandir one. Yes, near the Bhandir one, there is Vanshivat also is there. Where? There is a well is there, which name is? Where Shridham stayed there in the separation of Krishna. So, we have heard that katha of Vanshivat near the Bhandirvat. Chalo, now we are coming to the katha. Maharaji, we went to Kamyavan, so there is Nand Bhavan also is there. Yes, yes, Kamyavan is also there. Uma Didi lead us to there. So after thinking all these things, after hearing all the words the heavenly damsel Shri Radha spoke sweetly and jokingly, O most fortunate one, I consider you the most clever of all heavenly damsels in the celestial realm, because only you, your mind cut asunder by the sword of your strong eagerness to meet the flute player, are trying to find out the source of the flute songs. So now we are stopping here on the shloka number 31. So we will discuss tomorrow. Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. Maharaji, Krishna has got the form of Apsara. What is the katha is going on? So this is, we are reading the Granth of Prem Samput. Krishna got the form of the lady. So Krishna got the form of damsel from the heavenly planets. So Krishna went to Radhaji. So he went to the courtyard of Radhikarani and is standing there. So Radhaji asked so many questions to that lady. Where are you? Who are you? Where have you come from? who is your husband, what is the reason that, why are you so sad? So, but that lady was not replying, Krishna. So the, at last, Radha ji said, my father Vishwanu Maharaj for me brought one oil, ointment. So I have that. So if you feel suffering, any pain, any kinds of pain, so I will massage you. So the gradually, Krishna in the form of Devangana, he revealed so many, he revealed that where I am, who I am, where I have come from, all this. I am coming from the heavenly planet. So in this way, describes very nicely. So Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol. Okay, so we will discuss tomorrow, 31st shlok, Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol.
Madhuri, she is not coming, she is sick.